Let's just make sure that's not what's going to be happening here. So, Jaya Control. This was actually a Jeff Hoogland special. It was just so interesting to watch that I felt I'm going to play that. I'm going to play that. Like, if this is the immediate effect that him playing a deck like this had. Like, losing streaks are just so bad. Like, I kept losing multiple percents on a loss because I had like an 8-game losing streak. It was so painful. Turn four, Hellkite? I think I keep, and a shock to deal with some, like, any aggro kind of thing. They could play Hero of Precinct 1. Rude. Rude, rude, rude. Apparently, I'm in the thought erasure. Bracket, like, this is pretty rough. And you can still turn for Phoenix. If they have disinformation campaign, I don't know what I can really do. Oh, they're a mill deck. Okay. I mean, this lava coil is just gonna be dead. Pretty sure. Planeswalker would be pretty good. Of course, as I say that. Oh, I guess Ganto would have, like, flipped so good. Okay, can you mill some land? Jeez. Okay, so revitalize or hello, Professor Fans Pants. Thank you for the follow. Okay, let's no gamble, no future. Maybe, like, the main reason I would want to keep this shock is that if I did hit a Niv, then this shock does a lot of work. Okay, good. Just some, like, lava coil nonsense that isn't going to do anything here. Okay. So Jaya's, No! Okay, so I'm gonna have to keep the shock in hand so that I can discard it to a disinformation campaign.
Prepare yourself.
Oh, this is awkward. This is awkward. Oh, this is, At least I have a clock on the board now. Oh, please, not a thought erasure. No, no! You're rude, opponent. So rude. I definitely want to keep plussing. The question is whether
requires sacrifice.
I need a shock or not? I think I'll filter one. Because I do want to make sure I have enough lands. I'll keep... Whoa, that was weird. So I don't even know what her emblem actually is. You get an emblem with, you may cast instant sorcery cards from your graveyard. So essentially they all get flashback. Okay. We're gonna get all these shocks. Oh, I heard you like shocks. I only need to cast two shocks? Seems good. Oh, this is gonna be funny. Okay, so I think I have to do it in control mode. Oh! What? What? What the heck did I press that it just passed my entire turn? Was that alt control? What the heck? Shift and enter. I couldn't have possible. How could I have hit shift and enter? Well, I mean, I think they're dead anyway. So, I need it to be in full control so I can do this. Ooh. That's my target. Copy that. Yeah, yeah. This sucks, because they should just be dead. So they go up to 13? Is essentially what I see from... Like, they should have another absorb? Do they not? They're 9. So this gets to be a little tricky. So I have one more expansion in my deck. Oh, that sucks so much. That it skipping my turn just. Let's see. They draw, so that was 4 cards. Okay, that's something. That's 8 cards, yeah. Oh, this is terrifying. Okay, well that doesn't do anything. It does mill me for 4. But they're dead, so... Dissolve all. Yeah. Easy peasy. Well, let's see what my 2 cards are. Well, I don't want the mountain. It was easy. It was easy. Jaya carried me. So they're a mill deck. So the negate seems good. No, I don't want the fiery cannonade. Man, it has been really laggy. Yeah, I think not getting countered makes Niv really good. The Hellkite can do a lot of damage. Yeah, I think the Hellkite might. No. The Hellkite is actually a good threat. I had to just check myself for a second. As much as Jaya was really good there, she can't close out the game, like, 100%. Whereas the Hellkite going on turn 5, 4, 4, might gonna do quite a bit of damage. Just... Nope. That's a big pile of nope. Like, a bunch of blue spells, a basic mountain. I don't think I need another island. If it had been, like, Sulfur Falls, I might have been tempted, just because it makes so many of my draws live. I think it was still on, like, full control. Take my Hellkite. What a shock. I also hate mulliganing versus Thought Erasure and Disinformation Campaign. Luckily, they also mulliganed. I believe I'm gonna have to discard the shock to a Disinformation Campaign. They know I have the Sailor means. So one thing to note is that either the Sailor of Means or the Sarkhan would have meant I can cast the Hellkite next turn. Me wanting to play around a Quench or something of that sort is why I rather get the Sailor of Means countered, right? I think getting the Hellkite down as quickly as possible is the most important factor. And I'd rather give it haste and get aggressive. So, while the ability would allow me to start doing 2 extra damage each turn, that's not realistic because I do still want to be using my mana for the next couple turns. It was also very likely that they would have a removal spell at this point. So, that definitely played a factor. Now, this is interesting. And I think because they could have a negate. They have a negate. Interesting. Now, does that mean they have a removal spell or they have a counter spell? This would be a removal spell, unless they're in full control specifically. But it looks like it's actually pausing, like it's the arena pause, and then they're just spamming pass. So I'll gamble. No gamble, no future. I'm not gonna actually discard the shock. I don't know what's on the top of my deck. I'm gonna have to discard whatever it is anyway. If they have a disinformation campaign. So why discard possibly a Niv-Mizzet? Okay. No peace in defeat. That's a little sad. Cast a blue spell, mill me some. I do have 4 damage in my hand, you know. Give me 4 more turns and I can just burn them out. Right? They could have a moment of craving. It would. I mean, that's. I was a no. Come on. Something good. Something good. What? It would be. Oof. 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 It's like this would have been kind of bad if I.
You can turn anything into a pile. Pyromancy requires quickness of mind.
No, I'm not gonna discard these shocks on this turn. Ugh. Because I can still, if I draw a Niv-Mizzet, I can cast both of these, turn them into lightning bolts. It's likely that next turn, because I want to hit a Niv as quickly as possible, that I do. Uh oh. Oh no. Did they get me? Just resolve all. Ugh. That's pretty brutal. What do I have left? So that's. There's one expansion explosion, or both of them. How many cards can I afford to, because, well, they already did Chemist's Insight, so if they have another one, that's a 4-8, and if they did it twice, that's 16, so I'm pretty much dead. So I just have to hope to hit something good.
I need this.
I don't know what I have left that can, because that's one Hellkite. That's all the Hellkites. That definitely makes things. I don't know if the Sailor Means is gonna have time to get there. But I have to hit something really good. I think there's still a Niv in my deck. They have a Chemist's Insight undead. So it's kind of funny that I want to actually do that search, like do the scry right away, so that if there was a threat, I could put it at the bottom and hopefully have one turn to not die. A Niv, I guess, doesn't even save me. That doesn't help. Okay, so this is actually, they have to have an absorb, don't they? So I need to make blue and blue, I guess. Oh, wait, what? Yeah, I was dead. Like, so that mills me for 4. I'm so... Wait. What happened here? It's 3 bread. Oh, right. No, I tapped on this upkeep. Wait, like, so was I counting the sulfur falls? Yeah, so all I can do is one shock in response. I'm dead. Yeah. Those enchantments are pretty brutal. And that wasn't really... They got a good thought erasure, and I didn't like... That dragon getting removed, the following turn, that was 4 damage there. Was it possible that I just Jaya ultimate? Maybe it was that I just got greedy by trying to play the Niv, because I could have... I would have had 6 mana, so I could have cast 4 shocks. Yeah, no, I got super greedy there. And because I miscounted my mana, I just way overcommitted. I mean, this is my second game with this deck. So, the unfortunate part being they get to untap and Thought Erasure. And I think I'm okay with... Okay, that's completely fine with me. I want to get threats. That's exactly what I was looking for, is just being able to... I want to make sure I do get to the 5 mana mark. But... It's definitely going to be interesting. Okay. This is going to get painful. There's going to be a lot of deck damage, but... It means I'm most likely going to flip this Ascanta really early. So it could even be that... Okay, yeah. We'll take that. That's one of the better lands I could have drawn. And they're naturally going to mill for a whole bunch. Thought my kid was getting dropped off early. It's just one of my cats being a little noisy. It's also possible that since I'm getting milled... I was thinking that I'm getting milled, I don't want to draw as many cards, but that doesn't make that much sense, specifically since they're more ramp cards, and they're fulfilling that purpose. Don't actually care about, I already got a 5th land. I still don't want to just put things into my graveyard. This is a turn, they definitely have absorb, and I can afford to play around it. Heck, I'll be able to Niv-Mizzet the following turn and have negate back up on top of it all. That's gonna be a thought erasure. They have the absorb, but at least it's gonna be one of my threats resolved, so there's that. Oh, haha. That was I forgot to actually just let all these mill cards resolve. Yeah, I just wanted them to mill that mountain. Wait. Oh yeah, they countered the negate. They take the Niv? Yeah, right. 1000% you take the Niv there. So what do we got here? We've got a Phoenix and the Dragon? They don't even have double block, so they can't remove both. This is a case where I think I do play the Dragon as a 5/5. No, it's definitely a 4/4 here still, because if they don't have Vraska's Contempt mana, and if they do have a Mortify, they kill the Hellkite anyway, not the Phoenix. So getting the 4 damage out is probably one of the better things I could do. Milled my Nibs. come on. I wish it hadn't tapped my Ascantos like that, but sure. Because I would have preferred to Ascanta versus use the Treasure Cove. They need Swamp Kaya, Cleansing Nova. Okay, that works. Let's just see if I don't think I have another negate left, right? Like, 1, 2. Okay, there would have been one. So now I just need to hit a shock. But first, let's draw, right? Yeah, let's draw here. Of course. Well, that's awkward. That was really awkward. I guess I should have Ascanted first? Like, what the f- Like, wow. What do we even have left? Expansion? Shock. Shock.
This isn't a fight you can win.
Reverse! Okay, so if I play Niv, I only have 3 available. So let's do a Ascanta first. I do still have shock, right? Like, I still have 1, 2, I have 2 shocks left. I guess this means if they cast any spell, they die. Like, that's pretty brutal. Just missing the Ascanta. They can't mill me without...
We need to move quickly.
I guess they could have another Teferi. Oh no. So there's 1 shock left in my deck. They cast a spell, so I draw a card, so they die. Niv's pretty good. That took a bit. We'll play at least one more after showing off this deck. Like, let's see how long that actually took. That was a half hour. Yeah, so we'll try one more, and then I'll probably cut the video off for this showcase, and then I'll be switching over to my blue-red Pauper deck. So, Jaya seems pretty good with Niv. Like, there's a lot of that just being able to either draw naturally, so improving your card quality that also turns into a lightning bolt that is really good, but there's also the option to get extra mana to cast spells after Niv, so you could play Niv and then still Lava Coil Shock and, you know, get some good removal going. I'm gonna lead with the Steam Vents. I don't want to take two. I don't know if they're aggro or not. But I like that I do have this curve of removal into Phoenix. It sucks if I'm playing versus Esper or something. But no, we're playing versus the White Weenies. This actually becomes really, really good. The one sort of issue we could run into, I don't think I'm worried enough about a Hunted Witness to really care. I won't likely be scrying next turn unless they play a Benelish Marshal. That would probably have been something I would want a Lava Coil, so I would scry in that case. They have a really... They must have a Conclave Tribunal. Now next turn, knowing I will not be able to cast Niv, I likely will want to scry, because I want to hit that fifth land at the very least. Do they not have the Tribunal? Do they just have Venerated Loxodons? They could have like three or four more land, but that would seem somewhat suspect. Okay, fair enough. So, this turn I'm going to Lava Coil the Marshal. They will attack for 12, at least. Well, actually, they're going to attack for closer to like 16. So, I can't afford it. I actually really need to hit like a Shock. That was not exactly the best for me there. Yeah. Well, that is definitely a draw that they could have. Yeah, I'm not 100% sure we can play till the late game with these. Although there is something to be said that Jaya can then also cast Fiery Cannonade. That's kind of a funny interaction. The treasure map, I don't think we're gonna really have time for. It's possible the same can be said for Sarkhan, but... No, he just, like, hits so hard. Yeah, I think we just go down on treasure maps. Thank you. Okay, fire cannonade. But that's a little bit easier pill to swallow there. Oh, I can copy their unbreakable formation. Uh-huh. Combo. Come on, opponent. You need to save the mulligan to 5 for when you're on the play. I mean, I'm okay if you mulligan to 5 in both game 2 and game 3. But I okay. I can understand that. Being on the draw, does that change anything? Like, no, I think I still need to have some proactive plays with the Ascanta and the treasure map. I mean, so like when you're mulliganing to 4, why waste another 5-10 minutes, right? Like, just like you have to have an insane draw. So they do nothing? Like if they have to play some 1 and 2 drops. I think because this gets me an early dragon and I have some removal, that it's, I kind of have to keep it. Now I have a shock, I have a lava coil, they mulliganed. So getting to trade 1-for-1s are a little better for me. I just realized I won't be able to shock if they have a Benelish Marshal. I was thinking, okay, I can shock if they play a History of Benalia. But that doesn't... They have... Snubhorn Tron, what do I do? What could they have in their hand? I'm gonna filter one of these islands away, or maybe the steam guns.
You will feel the lick of my flames. I'll show you unhinged.
No, I think the island is the correct thing to pitch. So next turn I can have a Niv-Mizzet. If they don't Conclave Tribunal. Or do I I think because I can still play the 5-5 next turn, whereas I can't Niv this turn. They have a Conclave Tribunal, they swing here, and then they still have to kill Sarkhan, and then I can play a 5-5. That's definitely a really good sign for me. So that's gonna die pretty easily. I'm going to cast this removal spell, like, no matter what. Yeah. Oh, this deck! Ooh! Spicy! Like, that is, It definitely helped my mono-white opponent, Mulligan. You know, and just, like, conceded game 2, but that was pretty sweet. So, I'll end that part here. And we're gonna switch over to... the Singleton event. Oh, I guess Stream Decker probably didn't have this Jaya Control deck set up properly. That's definitely a mistake. So I'm just gonna, I guess, I'm gonna have to like restart the stream to make sure that this all separates. Sure. Everything gets updated here with Blue Red Singleton. It's quite a beauty here. Jim Davis was someone who was playing with this list, and it looks so good. I immediately went 5-0 with it in the first run, and it's like, yeah, no, this is legit. So I'm just gonna make sure that it is on my stream decker. And then we can enter into this event. I should have time to complete one of the singleton, hopefully get a 5-0 and have enough time before my kid gets home. I just want to make sure all my titles are correct. So let's go live. Player one. Ready? I don't know if player one is ready. Well played, opponent. Well played. So for the following turn, I could still theoretically lightning strike, and then I can also Banefire. So I do have two mana plays for at least two turns if I did need to sort of fix my curve out. At this point, the Lightning Strike isn't really going to do anything. It's not going to add an extra point of damage to the Lava Runner. It could theoretically be seen as being more efficient for my mana. But it's also possible next turn I just want a risk factor. Combo. Considering I definitely want to hit another land. Oh, nailed it. Dang it. Look, I still don't have any spells for this lobber. Opponent, please. I gotta be like this. So this is awkward, but if they, okay, they didn't negate that. Well, I don't think that they have any spell. What? Okay, they do. Oh no. Do I Banefire for one? I guess. I was really like trying to figure out if I should have attacked with the Lava Runner. I got punished super hard. This is not good. It's no bueno. It's no bueno. They know I'm drawing this, and they obviously don't care. I think I'm gonna risk factor. I don't see myself getting ahead here by rough. And they have absorbed. Come on. if I draw a land, I also get to just kill Teferi. And luckily this is Singleton, so it's not like they can... They can just play another Teferi. Play a frickin' Khorne!
I will defend my ally. Awaken!
Why does he Why does he spawn with... Yeah, I think I'm done. Well, that's not good. That was... I guess... Dang, that freaking Warrant Warden. I got played by Arena just skipping through. This is like, oh, yeah, they don't have a counter spell and they don't have a removal spell. Oh, and the removal spell is only active once I have, like, I'm attacking with a creature, so yeah, I guess that kind of makes sense. We're playing some sort of Siltai. I think I want to draw a card anyway, since I'm likely to just cast this Shivan Fire right here. It also means next turn I could play Wee Dragonauts. And if I draw a land, an untapped source, no matter what it is, I can play Wee Dragonauts, then Rekindle in Phoenix, because the Wee Dragonauts will cost 3. I'll have an untapped land, then the Steamkin can give me 3. So that would be a pretty insane draw. Now, this is getting a little cheeky, but I want to attack for 4. Then if they block, yeah, I don't play anything, but if they did block, I don't sacrifice, like, if they put any damage on the Steamkin and you try to add mana, it goes to being a 1-1, it dies. So, just, you gotta be careful with that one. So they can kill my Steamkin or the Dragonauts, but that's not terribly concerning. Yeah, and they only kill the Ground Pounder, so that isn't too much of an issue. I think I do this first, because if they take 4? No, I guess they're not dead. But they likely let me draw first. And if I draw 1 mana spell, something. Okay, so, kill Frasca, hit them for 4, and then I get to play a 2-3? Is that what it is? Yeah. Get a nice 2-3 flyer. Which puts me at having 4 damage or a bunch of cards. Feels good. Feels good. You killed the Wee Dragonauts. I mean, Sarkhan was really unsealed in our blue-red deck that we were playing in Mythic. That enchantment is nothing. A Sarkhan's unsealing deck. There's been so many, like, cool things since Allegiance came out that I don't even know if, Mr. Sarkin's unsealing has been tapped into. Getting to attack for two in the air seems really good. And then next turn getting to play a war boss. Do they have this? Okay. Wrong choice. That's why you wait till your opponent is attacking. I guess they could have been trying to play around dive down. Starting next turn, I likely will start discarding to draw a card. That's actually pretty much the one of the reasons I would want to do this. they have a counterspell or Vraska's Contempt, I assume. That's what it seems like. They could also just have like a Whisper Agent. That would suck. A Whisper Agent would suck. Huh. Yeah, that's nothing. Okay. Sure. That's kind of funny. I'm just gonna be like, yoink, mine. I think I do still want to play this Lava Runner. Feels so they know, Adelise, this Murmuring Mystic might be how I can actually win the game. Adelise allows me to attack this turn, which I think I kind of need to do. Do they have the counterspell? Okay, so I still have to attack with this goblin. Really, or do I? Yeah, I think I'd rather turn this goblin into, like, anything else in my deck. Because that's essentially what I'm doing by having this attack, is guaranteeing I draw two cards and I don't have to discard anything. This is a very curious following turn. That makes things pretty easy. We'll go with haste, because I'm thinking they have a removal spell. I didn't get to do any combat damage, so that sucks a little. Oh, and they kept something on top. No. Oh, and they have seven. Yeah, this is gonna get pretty bleak. Oh, these two control decks have really... Okay, come on. Okay, that's it. Yeah, that's game. My life total may be at 20, but I have no way of dealing 18 to them, and they're gonna draw two cards to like my one card. So yeah, that was pretty bad. We'll just try one more. I think I got a little unlucky there. Oh my god, yeah, like, yeah, can... I think it would be nice if it just said, like, play the same deck. Like, if it defaulted to the previous deck. Instead, we're stuck doing three confirmations. Ooh, this is a pretty aggressive hand, and the fact that I get to go Biomancer with Shivan Fire and Curious Obsession, that seems pretty spicy. Just in case my colors weren't good enough. Did you keep the one lander? Oh. Shucks. Oh, that's like the most annoying possibility. Why? I think I just adapt, kind of leave it back as a blocker. It is a wizard, that's... That's extra helpful right here. So they can't really attack? I mean, they could. Especially if they have something like a... Storm Strike or give plus one and First Strike or something like that. The old Boros rope on turn three. Seems about right. Everyone knows only blue's a thinking color. Yes. They can't chain whirler is something else to note there. Like a chain whirler could have been an issue. So I don't have any turn four play. Which means next turn I could play Adelie's attack and then just Curious Obsession on the Cinderwind over here with Shivan Fire and stuff and kind of go crazy on turn four. Well, yeah, that's what my opponent's doing right now. Lay into Subtle Wreckage next turn. I mean, at this point, if they play a fourth land, do nothing, and pass, I am willing to play into Subtle. Around. Like, I can just keep hitting for two. Oh, opponent. Opponent. No. Bless your heart. I've got seven in the air for next turn. This is looking much better. Much, much better. Turn turn two, Pyromancer, turn three, possibly a Gutter Snipe. And I'm on the play, so I could also have Charter Course plus Wizard's Lightning. I mean, that's a bit of a nuisance. It's like a 2-3 is pretty good. Could they be Arcades deck? What is this? A put? So you gotta kill it, not just deal damage. Well, I don't have to get aggressive this turn, and I'm not worried about taking 2 damage. Conclave Tribunals. Like, that's an issue. That's something I'm a little concerned about. Go ahead and kill that. Okay, I'm pretty far from casting this dragon, but I also think I don't need this Pyromancer, like that's gonna take too long to get going. See, you just gotta play perfectly. Just gotta play perfectly sometimes. Oh no, they're gonna play a flyer. I do believe I played the dragon as a 5/5 though. For the frenzy. This puts me in a position where I can just kind of hit runner. Oh, that sucks. Go ahead and discard some stuff. Dragon? I don't know if it's really going to be able to do enough. There we go. Oh, yeah! Combo! So it's going to be possible that the following turn, I even just want to blow up this experimental frenzy. Oh no! How do you? Please don't gain life. Don't gain life. Don't do this. I'll play the one drop red spell. Try to trigger this Steamkin. Okay. That definitely gets to be awkward. This is to each player. Oh, that does work. So if I were to play the Spear Spewer, or activate the Spear Spewer, I could skewer the critics. So how do I do this? I think I have to play the Murmuring Mystic. This is gonna be 4, right? So that actually puts me in a bit of a weirder position. So I have to cast the spear. I guess I just don't do anything on my turn. And then the following turn, I can blow up this experimental frenzy at the end of the turn.
Do it for me.
I guess it doesn't necessarily matter since they're doing it on their turn, so.
Oh, dang it.
They're on to me.
My newest friend.
Which I guess I can't even really afford to do that this turn. Yeah, I have to see what's on top of my deck before I pop this Experimental Frenzy, because the cards in my hand aren't going to be enough. I need a few more spells. The nice thing is that they can only really afford to attack with the Shalai. He's doing the beams. Well, that's not the exact part I wanted to see. Ooh. Oh, perfect. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, this is... I'm popping off. I'm popping off, chat. I gotta make sure to do... I think I had the spectacle already, so that's fine. That was probably a little overkill. Banefire. Banefire. let's see. So, how many ways do we have to win here? This Banefire is for 6? For 5? And then the Gutter Snipe kills them. So the opponent. You really did need to kill the Frenzy. Oh, look at that! I got a 40 gems! Because I have so many mythics! I think I've put in $200 total since Arena has gone into open beta. And I still have 6,000 gems or something like that. If you can be decent at limited, like even you go 50-50 or whatever, the conversion rate of prizes, like you get 3 packs, which are 15 card packs, not 10 card packs or 8 card packs that the store ones have. So you're automatically getting twice as many cards, commons and uncommons for the most part, so like that's not extremely relevant. But when it comes down to it, your vault is gonna fill twice as fast through drafting, so that's a significant bonus there. I think I want to get the Wee Dragonauts in first, and I might as well attack with both and get in 4 damage. They're going to block the 1-1 anyway, so... Right, like... What?! Like, that was definitely a misplay on my part, but, like, they really needed to block. Like, that was... So they can only mill me for 12. At this point. So I can actually mentor the Wee Dragonauts. They have to double block. They take 4, 5, 6. Is that worth it on this turn? Because the other option is I don't attack with the mentor. They kill both of these goblins. They just take 3. And then they have 4... next turn. I think pumping this Wee Dragonauts is gonna be the better option. I don't think any of these ground creatures are necessarily gonna get through. And if I draw a removal spell, it actually is pretty huge. Except for two. They need at least three turn, four turns to kill me. Well, I'm definitely winning this race. And if they hit a risk factor, then they're super. Oof, this is I'd like to announce that Wizards is now going to have me as an artist for drawing lands. I think it's pretty hilarious if they do hit the risk factor. Which statistic on risk factor. Well, that's really freaking aggravating. So they have to do this before my turn. Oh, they have. Wow, that really sucks, because I should have been able to do it on my turn, and... Yeah, because if I have been able to do it on my turn, then I would have... Oh, doesn't matter. That was quite literally drawing 4-5 lands in a row. And my risk factor being in the bottom 20 of my deck. That was just a bit of the variance game. Like, any spell. Literally. Opt would have killed them, because it would have pumped the Dragonauts. Shock. Would have killed them just by itself for being able to deal the 2 damage. Heck, I could cast through or crush through, and that would have been lethal as well. Just gonna play creatures, Kravat into Gutter Snipe, and then start worrying about removal. It is worth noting that this would have been better as give your creatures first strike. Hopefully I draw a red source. If not, I think I likely have to pump or banefire this orator. That's not necessarily good for me. Because this orator is going to gain them a bunch of life at this rate. Them getting a one drop means they're most likely going to be able to play multiple creatures next turn. They get to attack for 2 each turn for free, because that Bugler has Vigilance. That's also significantly a pain. First Strike, Vigilance, Lifelink. I need to start hitting lands, really. He didn't play. I'm really sure. which makes me think that they have a pump spell. Trying to gain some tempo back. This also allows me to double block their bugler. So ideally that doesn't get out of hand. Yeah, them not playing a creature, like, we especially, like, that's really dumb, because they, if they had played this aspirant, they would most likely get to give it a send in, like, the next turn, but they also are blatantly saying, I have a combat trick. I'm really gonna have to take this, two damage. So, what one cost white spell do they have? And I think I'm okay with them trading the Healer's Hawk for Adelise. Because I don't think that they have something other than a +2/+2. Good, that's not a big creature. Hopefully I can hit a land. Interesting. Okay. I was gonna say it's slightly alarming if they didn't want to attack with the Danitha. Like there's kind of this warning. So I can't attack. It's not a big issue. Take some damage there. I really need to hit a land. This risk factor is going to be the most dead draw. I don't have. Unfortunately, a double block means I lose the Gutter Snipe too. But I think I have to. Yeah, I won't have the life the following turn to actually let the Hellkite stabilize me. If they have a combat trick, I'm in pretty big trouble. However, from here, I gotta play the 1/2 flyer, and I think I have to kill this Vanguard. Like, the Vanguard's gonna gain life, it can keep attacking into this fleet aerialist, whereas these, like, that's the only one that can really, like, attack in. And then it just trades. They should also attack with the Rust Wing, because it's most likely going to be a free point of damage. You don't attack with the Healer's Hawk, because I 100% chump that, but... Okay, I think I just got to go for the Frenzy. And get wrecked! Oh no! Bad. It's getting bad. Charmander. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Can I even afford to go to 4? I think I just kind of have to. Yeah, I guess maybe that's kind of a reason not to. tiny pump spell kills me. That's pretty much what it's looking like. Pass to blockers. Taking the two killed me. I just, most of my outs really were to cost removal spells. Like, or to cost creatures. Like, I don't think I had a ton of options there. Well, those weren't the most fascinating games, but I think hopefully I at least showed the power level of some of with those early draws. Right, let's see, how long has I'll be calling it here.